coming to you from the dark recesses of the proverbial Dawnforge pouch. This is episode 262 of the Shattered Soulstone. BlizzCon 2020 canceled. Today's podcast is brought to you by Audible. Get your free audiobook download. bit.ly/soulstonebooks2020. Over 180,000 titles to choose from for your iPod MP3 player or your real man phone. It is Tuesday, May 26, 2020, and it's me, Shazam, again. So I was honestly thinking about doing this episode yesterday, and then I was like, nah, screw it, just, I'm probably not going to be doing anything tomorrow anyway, so I'll just do it, you know, tomorrow like I usually do it. And luckily, I did do it today because we got some news dropped on us, and yeah, I was going to do it last night because I was waiting for the Minecraft, able to play that this morning, you know, 5 o'clock in the morning, I was waiting for that, so, you know, I had a lot of time in the middle of the night to make the show, and I just decided not to. I just continued to play Phantasy Star and went to the gas station and bought some soda and stuff like that. And then here it comes to find out today that, yeah, we got some news dropped on us. I did post the article in our Discord, and I, you know, it's running the rounds on Twitter and stuff as I speak. And it's like less than an hour old at this point. But the TLDR of the whole thing is they're canceling BlizzCon for 2020. They're thinking about doing an online thing, but it's not going to happen until early 2021. So the first BlizzCon that I was thinking about going to, you know, February, I said I was still on track to go. And then, you know, this whole pandemic stuff happened. And then there was some weeks there that I thought I would, you know, that I was going to be like in real financial trouble. But it turns out I'm not. And I would have had, you know, plenty of money to go to BlizzCon this year. And I can't go because it's not happening. So I guess my plans are, you know, get my house, get that all set up, save up money, and go next year. I would assume at this point that would be the plans, you know, in late May of 2020. It's my plans for end of this year, beginning of next. House BlizzCon next year. It sucks too, because I wanted to go on vacation. So, like, I haven't been on a vacation since, this may sound weird, but since I got laid off last time, and that was all the way back in 2003. And when I got laid off of my job back then, you know, worked in a factory, and you know, everybody 5 years seniority and lower all got the axe that day. And, you know, they put us through schooling, and it was only specific things we could go to school for. And, they would pay us, the government would pay us not very much money every week to go to school. So that's when I went to school to be an automotive technician. I went to a vo-tech as an adult student during the day with the kids for a year, and then I moved down here to Pittsburgh and went to actual college. But yeah, that was the last time I was on vacation, was like 2003, before I went to before I did my adult vo-tech stint. And then, I went to, car shows here and there, like the big car show in Pennsylvania was Carlisle. I went to that a bunch of times, but I wouldn't consider that a vacation because you literally drive there and drive back home the same day. But other than that, I really haven't went anywhere. I went to Ann Arbor, Michigan for SRT track experience. But I only stayed there a day too, so I wouldn't consider that a vacation. But them are all fun things to do. And, not many people get to experience them kind of things. But I wouldn't consider them vacations. Yeah, me going to California, getting on an airplane for the first time, that would be huge because, growing up in a really small town, never wanting to get on an airplane, and then being, I guess I'd have been 20 years old at the time whenever, Flight 93 happened, like 5 miles from my house. That kind of puts a damper on you wanting to get on an airplane. Almost 20 years later. It will be 20 years later once I go to BlizzCon next year. Get on an actual airplane. And the crappy thing is I won't be able to do it when I'm in my 30s. Oh, God, I'm getting old. The BlizzCon this year, if they're going to do anything online, it's going to be the beginning of next year at some point in time. The other news, I guess, for today, the GameStop exclusive, and this is what I don't understand. Like, when I seen the post from Adam, a couple weeks ago, and then he posted something today saying it was released and stuff like that, and then you click on the link, and you could order the thing, but you go to GameStop's website, and you have to pre-order it. You don't even, it's not buy it and get it delivered. It's a pre-order, but it says it releases today, which doesn't, I don't understand that, but it is what it is. I ordered mine. It is technically my first Funko Pop I've ever owned. So whenever I get it, I will show it on camera and stuff, but yeah, I started my Funko Pop collection with a Tyrael Funko Pop. And I'm half tempted to buy the 2012 one, which was also Tyrael. That one is fairly cheap, I think, on Amazon. You can't get it on Funko's website. You can't get it on GameStop's website or anything. So, I might try and find that one at some point in time so I can just have both of them. They're not really much different. They're just the wings are a little bit different, and that's about it. Like I alluded to earlier, Minecraft Dungeons came out today. I watched, a couple weeks, maybe even a month ago at this point, I watched some streams on Twitch about it. It didn't look like that fun of a game, to be honest with you. But I figured since I have Xbox Game Pass, I might as well use it. So I downloaded the game, had it pre-installed on my PC and on my Xbox. Ended up playing it on Xbox because all the reviews are talking about, like, when you try and go through, like, how do you put it, like, doorways, stuff like that, with the clicking, the, like, your normal movement on ARPGs, like, your character does all kinds of stupid stuff. So they said that a controller would be a better playthrough than the clicking style, because that people just, like, literally hated that. So I went ahead and decided to go play it on console. Played it for like an hour and a half this morning. It was all right, I guess. I'll put it this way. If I played through the game once and figured everything out, it's probably highly unlikely that I would die the second playthrough. The only boss that killed me was because you can, just like Diablo, you can only use your health potion once, and then it's on cooldown. And the boss put out the poison clouds all around him, and not knowing the mechanics of the fight and everything like that, I basically took way too much damage and just ended up dying because I stayed in there and I didn't run away. But other than that, I didn't find it too much of a challenge, really. I've only been, I think, four maps out of the 9 or 10 that they have right now, and they're all right, I guess. The I want to say the skill system's kind of weird, because you basically have two weapon slots and a armor slot. Weapon slot, one of them is basically a sword. Your other one's a bow. And then your armor is your armor. And then you basically click on your sword, you click on your armor, or you click on your bow, and they give you like three different choices. Like the one sword I got, you can get like 100% it's basically like 100% rare drop rate increase, and it can go up to level 3, which I can't remember if it went up by 50% or if it went up by another 100%. So rank 3, it could be 300% rare drop rate. And, you know, your armor, I didn't really notice anything like standing out with that kind of stuff. Like your swords, like increased damage, you know, obviously is another option. The bow is like, you know, faster attack speed. And I can't remember the other ones. Like one was like, I think the bow I have now, I added like poison damage to it, which seemed pretty neat. The first time I tried using my bow, like the only thing I tried doing was using my bow. Like halfway or three quarters of the way through the map, I couldn't use it anymore, and I couldn't figure out why. Until like two maps later, I figured out I ran out of arrows, and that's why I couldn't use it anymore. So I had to literally switch to a shield and go from there. But as of right now, like the bow that I use is basically a multi-shot bow. It shoots three arrows at once. So you can spam that button as fast as you can and mow things down. And it, at least with controller, if there's an enemy there, it's automatically going to target it, so it's not like you're going to miss. But you can shoot all your arrows in town and lose them all, and you don't have any arrows left. And then you have like three artifact slots. And your artifact slots, like right now, I have one. And they're all, these artifact things are basically skills that are on cooldown. And they're usually like a 30 second cooldown. And like one of them shoots out like a flaming arrow that does like 50 damage or something like that. Another one that I have right now is a wolf pet. It's basically, I have a wolf pet out, and it's got a health bar. And whenever you're walking around, he'll just, the wolf will literally go around and attack, you know, all the monsters that are on the map, essentially. It doesn't do very much damage, you know, at least the wolf companion I have right now. But, you know, that's the only thing I have, so it's the only, that's what I'm using. And the other one is like a, it's like a feather or something like that. It's basically just another, the way I'm seeing it is basically just another, a roll, like a dodge roll. You get a dodge roll, but it's on cooldown. I can't remember, it's only a couple second cooldown. But if you have this feather, you essentially have two rolls, and then, you know, one of them's on a really long cooldown, and another one's on a much shorter cooldown. But that's basically the gist of the entire game. I guess you go through the game, fight the final boss. You can go up a difficulty or whatever. Go through the game again. And it's basically grinding out higher level gear and higher level, you know, leveling your character up. And I seen on Twitter that they, because David Brevik liked it, they apparently made a secret cow level in Minecraft Dungeons, so, you know, we got that to look forward to find that. So I didn't know about it till, you know, a couple hours ago. But there's that. Yeah, that's basically the gist of Minecraft Dungeons. It's not very hard. I just have it on normal difficulty. I don't have it on anything hard. I'm not even level 10 yet, so I don't have very good items at this point. The last thing I'm talking about, and again, I don't know if you guys care about this or not, but I care about it because right now it is my favorite game. And last weekend they announced that Phantasy Star Online 2 PC launch is the 27th of May, which is technically tomorrow. You can preload it from the Windows Store at 11 o'clock tonight Pacific. I wish at this point in time, I wish I was on the Pacific side of America because I have to wait up till 2 o'clock in the morning to click an install button and then go take a nap. Because they say maintenance is going to be like 6 hours. So, I'm gonna sleep them 6 hours or so, hopefully, and hopefully the PC launch is better than the Xbox beta launch because I heard the first couple hours of that was pretty bad. But to entice people to play the game, I would assume that they have a whole bunch of buffs that are coming out tomorrow morning and they're gonna last an entire week. Like 50% more money drops, 50% experience gain, I think 50% rare drop chance. So there's all that to look forward to. It'll help you level up a lot quicker. At least a little bit quicker anyway. So yeah, I'll finally be able to use keyboard and mouse to play this game instead of a freaking controller, because God, I hate using a controller playing this game. Basically, it's like the Path of Exile freaking all the skills you can put and stuff. I think. Yeah. Well, no. Diablo has basically that amount of skills, too. There's another game that I can't remember. Oh, wow. It's basically like the WoW. Like the WoW skill bar. But you have to use your freaking D-pad and click one at a time, whatever one you want to use. I'd rather just click a button and be done with it. I never look at the map on a controller because you gotta hit like four buttons to get to the freaking map on a controller. And with PC, you're only gonna be able to hit one. It's a lot of quality of life changes playing it on PC than what it is playing it on a freaking console. I'm really starting to despise like consoles. I don't know if it's my Xbox, it being not an Xbox One X, it just being like an Xbox One S. But like it seems like portal in places and stuff like that takes way longer. Like you and somebody else can portal somewhere, and darn well that you have better internet than 95% of the people in America. Yet them people load quicker than you do, and get to the place quicker than you do. So it's got to be like the hardware in this freaking Xbox, and At least when we get on PC, I'll at least have the advantage again, because I know my PC is pretty good. I don't like the other stuff that I seen, like the other news. I don't know if anybody cares about it or not. Supposedly AMD cut the price of the Ryzen 3900 processor. I guess they're supposed to be $350 now or something like that. I looked the day I heard the news, which is I think Sunday-ish, and the cheapest one I found was, at least because I only checked Newegg, was $414. But the 3900X is supposed to be 350 at some point in time. So that's a pretty beefy processor for $350. I know I can run it. It would be an upgrade for me. I know it would be an upgrade for Tut. I'm pretty sure he could run it on his board. But yeah, I'm not upgrading until the fourth out, the Ryzen fourth gen comes out, because that's the last generation that's going to be running on my motherboard. So I might as well just wait, get that one, and never up. And when next time I upgrade, it would be, when I buy a new motherboard and processor. And I'm probably not going to buy the fourth gen right away. I'll probably wait till they go on sale and stuff like that. Because my 3700 right now is fine, and I don't see it not being able to run any game. I think my bottleneck right now is going to be my graphics card, surely not my RAM. And I posted this in Discord yesterday. The other, leaked information that I found was the 3080 Ti is supposed to be like somewhere between like 40 and 50% better than the 2080 Ti right now, and it's supposed to be cheaper. They're claiming, and this is as of May 11th, because that's whenever the video got posted. They were claiming 21 teraflops on the 3080 Ti. They're claiming that the 3060, which is like would be probably be like a $250 or a $350 card, would be on par with a 2080 Ti right now if they would release them. But they're not going to release them until fall, and they're not going to give the end specs, because they have no idea what AMD has in store and what AMD is going to release, because they didn't think that AMD could get above the 2 gig clock speed of a graphics card, because the 5700 didn't get above that. But then You know, you see the press releases and stuff for the PlayStation 5. And it's running at 2.2 gig clock speed for their graphics. And that's AMD. That's AMD, the next gen stuff. And then they didn't think that it would have. They didn't think that it would have the power of like a 2080 or anything like that. Like, you know, Nvidia is basically thinking AMD isn't going to have, you know, that good of a graphics card coming out. But then you get the press release for the Xbox, and supposedly the press release for the Xbox, the graphics running in that is also AMD. And the whole, I guess, kit and caboodle on that is the integrated graphics and stuff like that. But you got the graphics and the CPU and stuff like that. And the graphics is still putting out better than a 5700 XT currently. So, you know, Nvidia has no idea how much further AMD can go, because them are just consoles, you know. I guess AMD is, like, they had some leak or something like that of, I can't remember what it was, but it was like some, like, really good specs on stuff. And they were claiming that the clock speed and the power draw and stuff on that was basically the power draw and the clock speed and stuff of like a laptop, not a full-on graphics card for a desktop. So this fall, look for, and it's probably going to be a money war, and it's probably going to be a graphics card war between Nvidia and AMD at this point. And the only people that are going to be making out in this whole entire thing are the people that are going to be buying the stuff. Because if AMD comes out and says, you know, this graphics card, you know, whatever it is, whatever they want to call it, is, you know, it's going to, it's, let's say that they come out and say it's going to be 21 teraflops. Let's say it's going to be the same thing as Nvidia's, which, you know, I have no idea at this point in time what it is or if it isn't. And if they say that this graphics card's going to be $800, that's going to make Nvidia release theirs, and it's going to make them release theirs $800 or cheaper. And if you guys haven't noticed, AMD released a graphics card, I think the 5700 and the 5700 XT. They released it at a certain price. Nvidia dropped their price on their comparable cards. And then AMD a couple days later dropped theirs by $50. So, you know, it's gonna be a great winter to upgrade your graphics card. All in the new 3080s are gonna be PCI Express 4.0. So yeah, there's that. Which at least my board will at least have a graphics card that'll be PCI Express 4.0 then. You know, to match the PC PCI Express slot that I have. But yeah, I can't wait. Like, hopefully they're not like $1,000 and up again, because that's kind of ridiculous. Like, your whole PC costs you like $1,000, and then your graphics cards that same price. Like, that, like, to me is utterly ridiculous. But yeah, but that is, what is it? Oh, wow. Star Talk just hit 1 million YouTube subscribers. They're having a live stream. It's Neil deGrasse Tyson, by the way, if you guys didn't know. Yeah, it's gonna be a good winter to upgrade a graphics card, no doubt. And the fourth gen Ryzen, I have no idea when them are coming out. I would assume fall or next year. I can't remember the release date on them currently. Yeah, BlizzCon canceled for 2020. Online thing probably 2021 early. GameStop exclusive Terrio Funko Pop. Ordered mine. Minecraft Dungeons, went over that. Phantasy Star Online 2 PC launch, went over that. That's basically it. There isn't a Blue Notes. I did check that, other than the BlizzCon thing. The I was looking over the forums all day today, and it was just people complaining about everything under the sun. If you guys think of something that they would complain about, there's 9 chances out of 10 there's a thread on the main page of the forum complaining about it. So yeah, if you guys are into lore of Diablo 3 and Diablo in general, you can go to bookagen.net. She does 15 to 20 minute episodes, give or take, once a month, and they're pretty interesting. I think she's up to 20 right now. I don't know if she put out 21 or not. I haven't looked on the YouTube section of our Discord in a while. She does a pretty good job at the lore. She does a lot better of a job than some YouTube videos that I see. I'll tell you that. And, bookagen.net. The only other thing that I can talk about, I guess, this week is other media, obviously. And it's been I watched The Big Bang Theory. I didn't watch nearly as much as I did last week because I got tired of bringing the Apple TV back and forth from the bedroom to the living room and stuff. But I might do it tomorrow whenever I'm going to be playing Phantasy Star again. So I might watch a crap load more episodes. We'll see. But, I watched that. I watched, the new episode of Rick and Morty. I don't know how they get away with the stuff they get away with. If you guys think that South Park's bad, Rick and Morty Sometimes they turn that show up to 11, and like it is crazy. But I've been basically doing a Hulu, basically a Hulu deep dive into, because it was on my, like, some of these were on my Hulu's main page. So I watched them while I was playing video games, like, one day. And then I started looking for more of them. And then I just started watching them, listening to them while I'm playing video games and stuff. But, yeah, I took a deep dive into, basically people that, killed people from, like, the, I don't even know, I don't know when Pamela Smart did hers, but from basically the 90s all the way up until, mid-2000s, I guess. Anyone's that have documentaries about them. Investigation Discovery has a crap load of stuff on Hulu right now, and they have like a whole, I can't remember how many episodes, but they have the Casey Anthony, when she, when she got away with killing her kid. Lord knows she did it. And I don't know how she got away with it, but she did. And like the Menendez trial of the two kids that basically killed their parents. I guess their dad was a like a movie executive and stuff like that. And allegedly he molested the kids growing up, and the mom wouldn't do any, didn't do anything about it, and it basically drove them over the edge essentially, and they killed their parents. And then they're in jail for it, which, it's kind of weird. Like, you see certain people get away with stuff that shouldn't, and then you see other people not get away with stuff that you're like, it's kind of weird. But still, I don't know. But the two documentaries about that, I only watched one of them so far, and it was when I was going to sleep last night. It's called Eric Tells All, which is basically one of the kids, talking in prison about, why he did it. And, basically, he basically goes through his entire life history at this point. From the time he was a kid till the time, up until, that documentary was released, which I have no idea when that was. And the Pamela Smart, I don't know. I can't remember too much because I watch so many of these. It's like I'm only talking. I talked about all the ones I've watched, but like some of these, like I don't even remember some of them, like how they killed each person. Pamela Smart, that one. And then Jodi Arias, which that girl's a pretty messed up individual. I guess her boyfriend or ex-boyfriend or whatever was, dating somebody else, but was sleeping with her on the side. And this is a girl that's a bit loony, and she stalks people, so she essentially like hid in the bushes and stuff like that at her boyfriend's house, just to stare at them and stuff like that, which is kind of weird. And then, you know, one day she just decided to stab him about 30 times, and, you know, and that was the end of him. And they go through the whole documentary about it. He was a Mormon, and he converted her to be Mormon. And then, you know, stuff like that. He was pretty prominent in his church. I can't remember. Oh, and he was basically like a real estate agent and stuff like that. But yeah. That's basically about it. I went through a deep dive of people murdering people for some reason this week. And Conor McGregor, now the number one UFC welterweight contender. Nice. It's all the stupid stuff that pops up when I'm doing a show. Yeah, other than that, that's basically it. You know, it's basically the news on my week in a nutshell. Unfortunately, this is my last week of extended vacation. It lasted, whenever I get back to work, it has lasted, I want to say, let's take a look. No, it's 2 months and, but, I guess as of right now, it's 2 months. So, you know, 2 months as of 2 days ago, which is basically because I'm just going by 24th to 24th. But, it'll be 2 months and 1 week that I have been here at home, and unfortunately that comes to an end next Monday, and that's when I go back to work and start my life back at working on cars. But yeah, it's my last week of vacation. It's been fun. I've been enjoying getting paid to be a video game tester for the last couple months. I've quite enjoyed it. I don't like what it's done to my body, but getting back to work, it'll fix everything back up, I'm sure. You know, it'll just take maybe a month or two, hopefully, and I'll be back to, you know, what I was beforehand. And that's basically about it. I know I've put on some weight, and because I haven't really done anything. I should have got on this treadmill, but I didn't. If I'd have known it was going to take 2 months to be on vacation, whenever I got laid off, I would have probably just jumped on the treadmill at that point in time and been done with it. But, if, you know, not knowing if you're going to be off a week or whatever, you know, you just don't ever think about it. And then this time just keeps ticking away and ticking away and ticking away. And then before you know it, you're like months into it. And you're like, shit, I should have done this. And I didn't. But, yeah, it is what it is. But, yeah, that's about it for the show this week. We'll see you guys next week. probably do a show on Sunday or so because I have no idea what work's going to be like next week. I don't know if it's going to be dead or what it is, so I'll probably just end up doing it on Sunday and doing it, you know, doing it normal then. You've been listening to episode 262 of the Shattered Soulstone, your Diablo community podcast. This is an episode. You can find the show's blog, listen to the show archives, www.shatteredsoulstone.com. With your support, you can help the show grow. Become a Patreon today, patreon.com/soulstone. One thing I forgot to talk about during the show, which, you know, is a great time to just jump on in and say it right now, is I didn't talk about the PTRs because the PTR got delayed and we have no idea when it's going to be up this week. And that's basically, that's the news on the PTR. They delayed it and they don't know when they're going to fix the bugs or whatever for the PTR. So, you know, they don't know when the PTR is going to be up. But there's your news on that. Come join us in-game or in-game community and clan, both named Shattered Soulstone. Open to anyone who would like to join. You can also join us on Discord for the ultimate team and community-based experience. Find the Discord invitation link on our Twitter and Facebook page, as well as the Shattered Soulstone website. The show is powered by you, the listener. Send your contributions, thoughts, questions, and feedback to show at shatteredsoulstone.com. We love Twitter. Come join and tweet with us. You can find the show's Twitter at Shattered Stone, Dead Greed at Dead Greed 1812, and you can find me at Shazam081. We would like to extend a huge thank you to Medros of Dawnforge Productions for hosting our Loot Deviant show. You can find more shows from the Dawnforge at www.thedawnforge.com. Thank you for listening. Until next time, from all of us here at the Shattered Soulstone, over 261 episodes for your listening pleasure. Dawnforge.